What is poetry? Poetry, also called verse, is a form of literature that uses aesthetic and often rhythmic qualities of language, such as phonoesthetics, sound symbolism, and meter, to evoke meanings in addition to or in place of a prosaic ostensible meaning. A poem is a literary composition written by a poet using this principle. Poetry has a long and varied history, evolving differently across the globe. It dates back to at least to prehistoric times with hunting poetry in Africa and to panegyric and elegiac court poetry of the empires of the Nile, Niger, and Volta River valleys. Some of the earliest written poetry in Africa occurs among the pyramid texts written during the 25th century BCE. The earliest surviving Western Asian epic poetry, the Epic of Gilgamesh, was written in Sumerian. Early poems in the Eurasian continent evolved from folk songs such as the Chinese Xizheng, as well as religious hymns. The Sanskrit Rigveda, the Zoroastrian Gathas, and the Hurrian songs, and the Hebrew Psalms, or from a need to retell oral epics, as with the Egyptian story of Sinuhe, the Indian epic poetry, and the Homeric epics, the Iliad and the Odyssey, ancient Greek attempts to define poetry, such as Aristotle's Poetics, focused on the uses of speech and rhetoric, drama, song, and comedy. Later attempts concentrated on features such as repetition, verse form, and rhyme, and emphasized the aesthetics which distinguish poetry from more objectively informative prosaic writing. Poetry uses forms and conventions to suggest differential interpretations of words or to evoke emotive responses. Devices such as assonance, alliteration, onomatopoeia, and rhythm may convey musical or incantatory effects. The use of ambiguity, symbolism, irony, and other stylistic elements of poetic diction often leaves a poem open to multiple interpretations. Similarly, figures of speech such as metaphor, simile, and metonymy establish a resonance between otherwise disparate images, a layering of meanings, forming connections previously not perceived. Kindred forms of resonance may exist between individual verses in their patterns of rhyme or rhythm. Some poetry types are unique to particular cultures and genres and respond to characteristics of the language in which the poet writes. Readers accustomed to identifying poetry with Dante, Goethe, Mickiewicz, or Rumi may think of it as written in lines based on rhyme and regular meter. There are, however, traditions such as biblical poetry that use other means to create rhythm and euphony. Much modern poetry reflects the critique of poetic tradition, testing the principle of euphony itself or altogether foregoing rhyme or set rhythm. In an increasingly globalized world, poets often adapt forms, styles, and techniques from diverse cultures and languages. Poets have contributed to the evolution of the linguistic, expressive, and utilitarian qualities of their languages. A Western tradition, extending at least from Homer to Rilke, associates the production of poetry with inspiration, often by a muse, either classical or contemporary. In many poems, the lyrics by a character who is called the speaker. This concept differentiates the speaker character from the poet author, which is usually an important distinction. For example, if a poem runs, "I killed a man in Reno," it is the speaker who is the murderer, not the poet himself. Early works in history. Some scholars believe that the art of poetry may predate literacy and developed from folk epics and other oral genres. Others, however, suggest that poetry did not necessarily predate writing. The oldest surviving epic poem, the Epic of Gilgamesh, dates to the 3rd millennium BCE in Sumer, in Mesopotamia, present-day Iraq, and was written in cuneiform script on clay tablets and later on papyrus. The Istanbul tablet 2461, dating to 2000 BCE, describes an annual rite in which the king symbolically married and mated with the goddess Inanna to ensure fertility and prosperity. Some have labeled the world's oldest love poem. An example of Egyptian epic poetry is the story of Sinehe, 1800 BCE. Other ancient epics includes the Greek Iliad and the Odyssey, the Persian Avestan books, the Yasna, the Roman national epic, Virgil's Aeneid, written between 29 and 19 BCE, and the Indian epics, the Ramayana, the Mahabharata. Epic poetry appears to have been composed in poetic form as an aid to memorization and oral transition of ancient societies. Other forms of poetry, including such ancient collections of religious hymns as the Indian Sanskrit language, Rig Veda, the Vestan, Gathas, the Hurrian songs, and the Hebrew Psalms, possibly developed directly from folk songs. The earliest entries in the oldest extant collection of Chinese poetry, the Classic of Poetry, were initially lyrics. The Xizheng, with its collection of poems and folk songs, was heavily valued by the philosopher Confucius and is considered to be one of the official Confucian classics. His remarks on the subject have become his invaluable source in ancient music theory. The efforts of ancient thinkers to determine what makes poetry distinctive as a form and what distinguishes good poetry from bad resulted in poetics, study of aesthetics in poetry. Some ancient societies, such as China's, through the Xizheng, developed canons of poetic works that had ritual as well as aesthetic importance. More recently, thinkers have struggled to find a definition that could encompass formal differences as great as those between Chaucer's Canterbury Tales and Matsuo Basho's Oku no Homosumichi, as well as differences in content spanning Tanaka religious poetry, love poetry, and rap. Western traditions. Classical thinkers in the West employed classification as a way to define and assess the quality of poetry. Notably, the existing fragments of Aristotle's Poetics describe three genres of poetry, the epic, the comic, and the tragic, and develop rules to distinguish the highest quality poetry in each genre based on the perceived underlying purposes of the genre. Later, aestheticians identified three major genres, epic poetry, lyric poetry, and dramatic poetry, treating comedy and tragedy as subgenres of dramatic poetry. Aristotle's work was influential throughout the Middle East during the Islamic Golden Age, as well in the Europe during the Renaissance. Later poets and aestheticians often distinguished poetry from and defined it in opposition to prose, which they generally understood as writing, with a proclivity to logical explication and linear narrative structure. This does not imply that poetry is illogical or lacks narration, but rather that poetry is an attempt to render the beautiful or sublime without the burden of engaging the logical or narrative thought process. English romantic poet John Keats termed the escape from logic negative capability. This romantic approach views form as a key element of successful poetry because form is abstract and distinct from the underlying notional logic. This approach remained influential into the 20th century. During the 18th and 19th centuries, there was also substantially more interaction among the various poetic traditions, in part due to the spread of European colonialism and the attendant rise in global trade. In addition to a boom in translation during the Romantic period, numerous ancient works were rediscovered. 20th century and 21st century disputes. Some 20th century literary theorists rely less on the ostensible opposition of prose and poetry, instead focusing on the poet as simply one who creates using language, and poetry as what the poet creates. The underlying concept of the poet as creator is not uncommon, and some modernist poets essentially do not distinguish between the creation of a poem with words and creative acts in other media. Yet other modernists challenge the very attempt to define poetry as misguided. The subject of traditional forms and structures for poetry that began in the first half of the 20th century coincided with a questioning of the purpose and meaning of traditional definitions of poetry and of distinctions between poetry and prose, particularly given examples of poetic prose and prosaic poetry. Numerous modernist poets have written in non-traditional forms or in what traditionally would have been considered prose, although that their writing was generally infused with poetic diction and often with rhythm and tone established non-metrical means. While there was a substantial formalist reaction within the modernist schools to the breakdown of structure, this reaction focused as much on the development of new formal structures and the synthesis as on the revival of older forms and structures. Postmodernism goes beyond modernism's emphasis on the creative role of the poet, to emphasize the role of the reader of a text, hermeneutics, and to highlight the complex cultural web within which a poem is read. Today, throughout the world, poetry often incorporates poetic form and diction from other cultures and from the past, further confounding attempts at definition and classification that once made sense within a tradition such as the Western canon. The early 21st century poetic tradition appears to continue to strongly orient itself to earlier precursor poetic traditions such as those initiated by Whitman, Emerson, and Wordsworth. The literary critic Jeffrey Hartman, 1929 to 2016, used the phrase "the anxiety of demand" to describe the contemporary response to older poetic traditions as being fearful that the fact no longer has a form. Building on a trope introduced by Emerson, Emerson had maintained that in the debate concerning poetic structure, where either form or fact could predominate, that one needs simply ask the fact for the form. This has been challenged at various levels by other literary scholars, such as Harold Bloom, who has stated, "The generation of poets who stand together now, mature and ready to write the major American verse of the 21st century, may yet be seen as what Stevens calls a great shadow's last embellishment, the shadow being Emerson's." So that's some of the basics of what poetry. In my next video, I'm going to talk about the elements of what makes poetry. That's some of this video talked about the history of poetry. In my next video, I'm going to talk about what actually is poetry, what makes a poem. Let me know in the comments below, what do you think about poetry? Do you know how to write poetry? And who are your favorite poets? Who are your favorite musicians? I think of musicians as poets personally, but that's just my opinion. Let me know in the comments below, what do you think about poetry? Please subscribe to this channel to be part of the community, and please like this video. It really helps the channel out a lot. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Bye-bye.